Sean Pronger dumps the puck in. Brad May, Tyler Bouk with him. Kurt Sauer back to touch the puck, takes a bump on an icing call. And they're all nose-to-nose here in a scoreless game on Sportsnet. Now there's going to be a scrap. Brad May, out of his weight class, taking on Pete Worrell.
You gotta be careful on that first grab, and that's what they're trying to set up.
May throws one, now he's trying to grab him, get in tight, throws another right, and Worrell trying to throw a couple of rights, and Brad May's trying to get loose. There was a haymaker from Worrell, and down they go in a heap.
Well, Brad May will get A for effort here, and even though he might have tied the fight, he's gonna win it in the crowd's estimation.
Just for going up against Peter Worrell.
I don't think that haymaker connected. I just think it hit him in the back of the head and just sort of knocked him down. Look at this, eye to eye. The first grab's really important. You gotta watch where you grab and where he grabs. That one there is not where I'd wanna grab if I was Brad May. You'd wanna be in close, and finally he is.
Peter Worrell is one big man. Matt Cook against Steve Moore.
Ah.
Moore's trying to throw rights as Cook tries to hold on and get his bearings, and now Cook's trying to throw him.
Uh-oh.
His sweater's been torn off. Is he tied down?
Yeah.
Steve Moore, who is public enemy number one in Vancouver after the hit on Marcus Naslund.
Let's have a look at that hit. Moore comes across. Naslund's extended, and he goes right after Naslund and knocks him out. Yeah. In half here.
He has to show that he was tied down under the NHL's disrobing law. And you know what? I think the fans here really appreciate this. May for going with Worrell. And for Cook answering the bell.
I would agree with you.
He really needs to close the door here. There's still lots of time left for a very good offense, but it's 5-0. Steve Moore. And the onslaught continues as the Avalanche take a 5-0 lead, and Steve Moore tucked that one in. Passes behind Hayduk, forcing him to turn. Rob Blake can't dump the puck in. Matias Holen looking ahead for Todd Bertuzzi. The puck is out of his reach. Here's Rob Blake scrapping now with Jarkko Ruutu. Third fight of the game. Blake's throwing hard lefts, and Ruutu gets inside on him and grabs on.
Jarkko Ruutu always surprises me at how strong he is. Rob Blake is a big boy.
Jarkko Ruutu always surprises when he handles the big guys like that, and is so game. Not known as a scrapper, but he handled himself pretty well there.
He's really learned this part of the game. He tends to get inside and then land whatever he can.
A push, a hold, a shove, let's go.
Oh, that's pretty good. First punch by Blake, last punch by Jarkko Ruutu. Couple.
Oh, he hit the glass.
Oh, that hurt.
I think he had that elbow pad over his hand like a boxing glove.
Oh, that was a pretty good right.
Glad I'm 150 feet away from that. Ryan Allen slammed at the boards again by Steve Konowalczyk off the faceoff. Nothing lead.
Brad May just went right after a high note. And Adam footsteps in.
Says, pick me.
They don't know who to line up here.
May wants Heino. Pushes him. Heino's not going to go. Allen to Sean Pronger.
Guess who jumps on
the
ice?
Yeah, the police have arrived.
There we go.
Here we go. Brad May and Peter Worrell again. Round number two.
Peter Worrell jumped on the ice real quick.
rolled up his sleeves. Brad May gets in, throwing him to start. Round two, May, Worrell, complete. There's been some nastiness in this tilt.
Right off the bat, Brad May came onto the ice and gave it to Heino here. Just chatted with him, called him a few things that probably Heino didn't like. Heino didn't respond, but Peter Worrell did. Worrell jumped off. There was a quick change, and Worrell jumped onto the ice, and that's how this started. Tyler Bouk goes out to the blue line. There's the high stick, trying to get the puck out.
Steve Moore declined an invitation from Matt Cook last week. There's Brad May with a hit on Steve Moore. And now maybe some scores will be settled here. Moore is being challenged by Brad May. Korea, meantime, heads for the net, and his backhander is stopped by Johan Hedberg. Teemu Selänne can't find the handle in front of the net. Johan Hedberg stopped him. Korea, sharp angled shot by Darby Henriksen is stopped. In the meantime, Steve Moore had headed for the bench, so he'd only be challenged twice on that shift. Here's a chance in front. Brad May scores. And then he goes over and gives Abisher a push. Linden again passes off to Sopel. Sopel to the front of the net. May again scores. And May goes right back after Abisher in a repeat performance. And suddenly the Canucks are working their way back into this game.
I'm in your face. And here's the second one. A good drag and pull. And watch here. He goes right back after David Abisher.
To the net. Looks to Cook. And he couldn't tip the pass. Here's Olin with a big hit. A punishing blow on Alex Tanque.
Matthias Olin, who steps right up on Tanque and just nails it.
Darby Henriksen starts out. Steve Moore run into by Brian Allen. And the puck got up onto the Avalanche bench, and Steve Moore is challenged again, this time by Tyler Bouk.
This time it's Worrell and Bertuzzi come together.
Here's Worrell trying to get away from Bertuzzi, and he's hit hard by Salo. That, folks, is like felling a redwood tree.
Oh, he's hurt.
Worrell is hurt. Worrell and Bertuzzi right off the faceoff, a little hack and whack, and watch this hit.
Yeah, that's a good hit. That's a good clean hit. You know, Salo steps into Worrell. Now, this is a power forward. Todd Bertuzzi powers around his man, and it's at a foot. And then there's the hit.
Battles Derek Morris. Mutu's in this as well. Morris knocked down. He moves the puck ahead. And out comes Hall. Daniel Sedin threw a hit. His play continues. And now he's wrestling before he could get there. Daniel Sedin on Darby Henriksen.
And in the foreground or the background there, you can see Jarkko Ruutu getting tripped up.
High note on Henrik. And in comes Brad May with a whack in the back of the head. Why Iota?
It's true. And it's especially the way it used to be.
And sometimes it doesn't happen anymore.
Now Brookbank comes in.
And he wants Peter Worrell. Kurt Sauer starts into this fray. Ruutu's in the middle of it. Worrell's got a hold of him, and in comes Wade Brookbank with a base wash. And a pick me, please. Only penalty is going to be to Brookbank. Unless there's some misconducts here as well. Ruutu's being ushered off the ice. Let's join Dan. Orders for his shin guards came off. Thought he was going to step on it there for a moment. Sean Pronger pushing and shoving Steve Moore. Steve hasn't had a shift for a while, so nobody's been after him. Todd Bertuzzi after Steve Moore. Grabs his shoulder, having a little chat with him, grabs his sweater, gives him a whack, and piling on is Andre Nikolishin, and everybody's into it. Now we got a line brawl, and Hedberg wants Abisher. Johan Hedberg comes to center, and he invites Abisher, who points to the clock, and the score. Kurt Sauer being roughed up by Brad May. Oh, May just hit Kurt Sauer hard with a left hand.
Oh, Steve Moore's hurt really bad. Moore's head went into the ice.
And now they need a trainer on the ice in a hurry here. And the Vancouver trainer comes on quickly, and they need more than just the trainers. They're calling for medical help for Steve Moore. Steve Moore down in the pileup at center ice. An incensed Colorado bench. And the score settling has gone too far. Moving his legs, it looked like he tried to get up, and they just told him to stay down here.
Yep.
While we step out and take a break, 8-2, the Avalanche lead.
Yeah, the face of Steve Moore, his head goes down here. Bertuzzi goes after him, and he lands on him right there. And then the pile lands on Steve Moore. Looks like he's out at that point.
Another look at it. Bertuzzi wanted him, piled on him, and you can see that his head hits the ice and everyone else piles on, and that doesn't help. And that's likely to cost Todd Bertuzzi. The Windsor, Ontario native Steve Moore of the Colorado Avalanche is being taken from the ice with lots of great medical attention around him, looking after him here. After an ugly incident at General Motors Place in Vancouver in an 8-2 game with the Colorado Avalanche leading.
Crease and coming to center ice. And it was Bertuzzi at the end of a shift that suckers Moore and then takes him straight down. Big Peter Worrell, Jimmy's on the ice, and so Wade Brookbank's on the ice.
They bump shoulders. Brookbank's got some spirit for this. I'm not sure that Peter Worrell has any.
Well, Worrell went over and gave him a shoulder, you know. Then he didn't want to do it.
He was ready and eager at the start of it. Then get wrapped up by Brookbank. Peter Worrell getting some power play time here, and he's tough to move.
Yeah, he is. Brent Sopel and Worrell really went at it here. Sopel's wondering, how do you move that mountain of a man? The big guy.
Teemu Selänne watching him. There's a hard hit by Worrell on Brookbank. And a good hit, and they just skate away. Here's Worrell. Cook catches up to him and takes him into the boards. Brookbank's hit hard by Nikolishin. And Worrell comes in again. Worrell and Brookbank.
Yeah. This time it's Peter Worrell that's going to get the penalty.
And you can bet Stephen Walker and Dennis LaRue are just looking for a reason to get both of them out of the game here now. Brookbank comes back in and takes a shot at Peter Worrell. Heisman let him go, and now Lonnie Cameron is going to get Brookbank out of there.
Well, what happened there is Worrell got talking to the coaching staff of the Vancouver Canucks, and Brookbank came back at him.
And he was giving the linesman Mike Civic a handful. So both Brookbank and Worrell will now go to the penalty box with 2.5 minutes to go in this third period.
Budget Brake and Mufflers having a half price sale. Save one half on Investus brake pads and shoes, and one half on Gorlick mufflers. Sale in sight.
Peter Worrell still being restrained here. They're trying to get him out of the game. Mike Civic. It's a good thing it's a big man like Mike that's a linesman tonight here. He's able to at least try and control Peter Worrell. Lonnie Cameron standing there as well in case he's needed. And Worrell's being ushered out of the game here now. And that's it for his night. He was jawing with the Vancouver bench and still has a few parting words. And now he's trying to get at a fan who threw something at him. And he's tough to control now. They didn't have that protection over top in time. And it's stuck.
Now the fan gets ushered out.
Now Rick talking with Lonnie Cameron, having words with the Vancouver bench. My goodness, what a night. Rick Tocchet in his playing days was in a number of these sorts of things. He's been in an awful lot of rough, tough games. Pretty no-nonsense player. Joe Sakic led the way statistically along with Milan Hayduk, who had a hat trick. Colorado Avalanche have defeated the Vancouver Canucks 9-2.